From Almaty, it's the 28th Winter Universiad, day 4. And on this day, we'll go back to competition from day 3. Women's curling, China took on Switzerland, and also the men's ski jumping, the Normal Hill individual competition. And then from here today on day 4, the biathlon, women's 7.5 kilometer sprint, the women's speed skating 500 meters, as well as moguls for both men and women. From the Almaty Arena, curling action continues here, the 28th Winter Universiad. This is from day 3. It's China and Switzerland. Switzerland comes into this one with a 3-1 record, while China is at 2-2. Switzerland are the two-time defending bronze medalists. China won medal all time, and that was a gold in 2009 at home in Harbin. China needing a win here to stay close to that top four to get into the playoffs, while Switzerland tries to keep pace with the United Kingdom and Canada. We'll go to the third end. This is Meiji of China. She will spill a couple Swiss stones deeper into the rings. And now the final rock for Briar Herleman. And she will draw 4-3, Switzerland up 3-0. Now to the fourth end, the final stone for Herleman. Is not the skip, she throws skip stones, but the skip roll is played by Elena Stern. There you see a whole mess of rocks in the rings, and Herleman will freeze to the top of the Chinese stone. And now May with a chance to score here, and she will draw and count 2, closing the gap to 3-2. It's now 4-2. We move to the seventh end. Switzerland's final rock. And they will take out the Chinese stone, and now May facing some trouble. And with hammer here in the seventh, she'll get rid of one Swiss rock, but Switzerland will steal one. They go up 5-2. Into the eighth end. Switzerland in control, up by 3. Herleman will put up a guard. And now May with her final rock. She'll just nudge her stone to the button. To count 1, China down 5-3. Into the ninth, Switzerland with hammer. And May will draw to the top of the 12-foot. And now Herleman with an opportunity to come around that to regain a 3-point advantage. The Supers work hard to get that one into the 8-foot. Switzerland up 6-3. Now to the 10th end. China with hammer, but needing a miracle. Draw there just past that guard. China lying 2. Herleman here really needing to just get rid of one, which would force a raise into the rings by China, which would be an extremely difficult shot. And that will do it. 6-4 the final. Switzerland improves to 4-1. China falls to 2-3 here in women's curling action at the Almaty Universiad. Yesterday on February 1st, the men's individual normal hill competition took place at Sunkar Ski Jumping Complex here in Almaty. There you see the crowd on hand for the evening affairs. As the athletes get themselves ready, we have had some fog issues over the course of the last couple days, but it did clear up enough for this competition to get off. Here's Aljaž Vodan of Slovenia. Still has the team competition to come after this individual one, and he's happy with that opening jump. ...128.2 points on a distance of 103 meters. Now here's Naoki Nakamura of Japan. He's had three top 20 finishes at a recent Continental Cup event in Sapporo, Japan. So he's looking to build on that here in Almaty. And a good jump for him, 100 meters, 134.2 points. Now Thomas Lochner of Austria. He was 18th in this event in Slovakia at Universiad in 2015. Good solid telemark landing for him. He'll move into third spot with 127.1 points. Now from the Czech Republic, this is Česmír Kozíšek. He too was at Universiad in Slovakia in 2015, finished 17th in the normal hill individual. Bit of a struggle on the landing there, but he holds it. And he'll move into third spot at this point. Now Mikhail Maximochkin of Russia. Competed at the Russian Olympics in Sochi in 2014, finished 30th in this event. Won a bronze at Universiad in 2013. And there you see the results after the opening round. Nakamura followed by Maximochkin. Now to the second jump. This is Thomas Lochner trying to move his way into a podium spot. He's been jumping well, had second and third place finishes at an FIS Cup event in the United States last week. Good landing for him. 261.2 points overall. Now Maximochkin gets the signal from his coach. And a good jump there for the Russian. Good control through the air. And a relatively clean landing. Moves into top spot, 263.4 points. Now Nakamura. Trying to see if he can move onto the top of the podium. Got a great shot there of him against that dark night sky. And Nakamura does just that, moving to the top of the podium, 265.8 points. He wins gold. Maximochkin of Russia wins silver. And Thomas Lochner of Austria moves into third spot to take the bronze medal. And there you see the three medalists in the men's normal hill individual competition. In the beautiful sunshine here at the Alatau Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex, this is the women's 7.5 kilometer sprint event. Beautiful day, minus 3 degrees, very little wind. So perfect conditions for these athletes as they warm up and get ready. Along this 7.5 kilometer route, they will shoot twice, once from the prone position and once from the standing position. And there is Anastasia Egorova of Russia. She was 13th in the 15 kilometer race earlier here in Almaty. And there's Yulia Zhuravok of Ukraine. And there's Yana Bondar of Ukraine. She won two bronze medals at Universiade in 2015 and a silver in the mixed relay in Trentino in 2013. There you see Bondar just getting up. One penalty for her. There's Larissa Kuklina of Russia. And there in bib number 27, Galina Vishnevskaya of Kazakhstan. Now back to Bondar. Here in the standing position. One penalty for her, so she misses one target on each of the prone and standing rounds. There is Egorova. She will cross in a time of 22 minutes, 19.8 seconds. Currently, she's in top spot. There's Kuklina. Goes clean through the prone shooting round. And well into that tuck position, makes the turn and continues along this course. Passing there, Jessica Patterson of Canada. Now to Vishnevskaya. There in bib 27, goes clean in the standing shooting round. And there you see, that's bib 13, that's Zhuravok of Ukraine. She would end up in fourth place. Egorova still on top. And there you get a look at Bondar. Eighth in the 15 kilometer race earlier here in Almaty. Looking to improve on that here today. And there is Bondar coming through, trying to catch Egorova. And she'll do it fairly easily in a time of 22 minutes, 5.9 seconds. And there's Vishnevskaya. Now Kuklina, the Russian athlete. One penalty in the standing position. And now Vishnevskaya coming through. Silver here already in the 15 kilometer individual. And she will move into top spot. The former Olympian from the Sochi Olympics, currently in first place. The Kazakhstani fans delighted about that. And there is Kristina Cherna. You saw briefly there, bib 35 from the Czech Republic. She'd finished 14th. And there's Kuklina. Now again, a look at Cherna as she makes her way up one of the many hills here on the course. Back to Kuklina. She will not catch Vishnevskaya. We'll move into fifth spot. And there you see the final standings. Galina Vishnevskaya on home soil wins the gold medal to go along with her silver in the 15 kilometer event. Silver here goes to Yana Bondar of Ukraine and bronze to Anastasia Egorova of Russia. And there you see the three medalists in the women's 7.5 kilometer sprint. From the beautiful Medeu Sports Complex outside of Almaty, it is the women's 500 meter speed skating event. The sun has come out here today in Almaty after a couple days of snow and fog. So beautiful conditions for these athletes. First up, we'll take a look at Alexander Kachurkina of Russia taking on Kin of China. This is the first of two races for each of them. And you see Kachurkina there now in the outside lane. Set a personal best 2 weeks ago of 39.49 in Italy. And she'll actually better that here today, 39.44. So a new personal best for her. Next up, it's Kim of Korea and Sha of China. Kim Hyun-jung, 24th in the 500 meters at the Sochi Olympics. You see her there on the inside. Fairways ahead of that first place pace, and in a time of 38.80, she moves into top spot here in this first race. Next up, Yamada of Japan and Tsujimoto also of Japan. Tsujimoto on the inside. You now see here on the outside lane, a little behind that pace set by Kim. She'll move into second spot, 39.13 seconds. And there are the standings after the first race. Now to the second race. Here's Kachurkina again. Set that personal best in the first race. Up here against Aidova of Kazakhstan. Aidova will now move to the outside lane and Kachurkina to the inside. Aidova starting to labor a little bit. Kachurkina looking quite strong down this back straight to the finish line. And Kachurkina will set her second personal best of the day, 39.26 seconds. Now it's the final pair. Kim of Korea taking on Tsujimoto. Kim won junior gold in the 500 meters in 2013. And Tsujimoto actually set her own personal best of 39.13 in the opening race here today. Now down the final straight, Kim with a significant lead. And Kim Hyun-jung of Korea wins the gold medal. Arisa Tsujimoto, in a total time of 78.52 seconds, will win silver. And Alexandra Kachurkina of Russia, with a total time of 78.71, will claim the bronze. And there you see Kim pushing right to the finish line. And she will celebrate her gold medal win here in the women's 500 meters. They're receiving her flowers. Kim Hyun-jung, gold medalist here in Almaty in 2017. On a beautiful sunny day here at Shimbalak Ski Resort, it is freestyle skiing. First up, the ladies' moguls. The men will follow. In this competition, we have the defending gold medalist from Grenada, Yulia Galasheva of Kazakhstan. There you see the weather conditions. minus 5 degrees Celsius, but a beautiful, clear, sunny day after some heavy clouds and snow in the Almaty area over the last couple days. This is Katarina Ramsauer of Austria. She was at Universiade in 2015 and finished ninth in the mogul competition. All athletes today will be chasing Galasheva. There's the second jump for Ramsauer as she makes her way down to the finish line. She would score 52.05. Next up, here is Anastasia Pervushina of Russia. Two top 10 finishes in FIS events in Russia back in December. So she has been skiing well. Working her way diligently through these moguls. And her final jump leads her to the finish line. She would score 62.13, so she's currently in second spot. Now here's the aforementioned Galasheva. Gold at moguls in Granada, gold at the 2011 Asian Games held here in Kazakhstan between Almaty and Astana. Also competed at the 2010 Olympics in Vancouver and then had a seventh place finish at the Sochi Olympics in 2014. And the front flip there to finish it off, and Yulia Galasheva of Kazakhstan on home soil will easily win the gold medal, 73.80. Well ahead of the silver medalist Pervushina. There you see that front flip. And Ramsauer of Austria, well back, but will claim bronze. Now to the men's side. In this competition, we have the gold, silver, and bronze medalists from Granada in 2015. You're looking here at the gold medalist from there. This is Pavel Kolmakov of Kazakhstan. Along with his gold in Granada, he was 10th at the Sochi Olympics in 2014. And a good run for him. He'll score 76.95. Now the bronze medalist from Universiade in 2015. This is Sergei Shimbuev of Russia. His first jump, working quite quickly and well through the moguls. You want to see good controlled movement as he makes his way to the second jump. There's the Iron Cross. He'll get across the finish line. And he will just inch ahead of Kolmakov. Now the defending silver medalist from Granada, Dmitry Reichard. He's skiing here on home soil. Through that first aerial, working very quickly here through the moguls to the second jump. Really solid, clean upper body. There's the second trick, a little bit tough on the landing, but Reichard with a really good performance here. He will move into top spot. Gold medal for Reichard, silver to Shimbuev, bronze to Kolmakov.